Now this is a different breed of sheep. Here he comes, Bruce the Hawkman. Developed in South Africa way back in the 1930s. What's his job? Is that black hair? Self-shearing wool. You don't have to shear him. I deal for my star money. You don't have to shear him, but this is what you do. Rugby. Rugby and drive stuff. World's number one carpet wool sheep. Amazing fires. Let's take a look. Let's get him here. Get some of this wool. Here we go. It is like human hair. I said this Bible was amazing. Let's take a look. You roll it up like this. You blow on it. Hold it there. There you go. Now that is strong and smooth. Well, what's happening? Sorry. I said strong. Now we send that to countries like India and Nepal for the beautiful mats and their rugs. It's worth a bit of cash, so cash back, cash in. Lots of brothers up here, Samson and Aussie. Samson and Aussie. One of the oldest sheep breeds known to mankind. A great thing about this sheep breed, we have two lambs in 1 year. One in spring time, one in autumn time. Problem is, it's those wolves. Very hard on our sheepdogs, hard on our fences, and hard on us, the sheep shearer. Three Australian sheep farmers developed this great breed of sheep. Australia! Yeah. That's right. The Pole Dawson. Pole means to bring out the horns. Same sheep, but without those horns. Give me the Moon Brothers. Jake and Elwood. Now Jake the Suffolk, one of the most popular meat breeds in the world today. You'll find in USA, Australia, Japan. What an ass market, you can't beat Suffolk. Beautiful fried meat. Variety in the market, you've got to sell Suffolk. They cross the Suffolk, well this little guy here, my friend Captain, the slowest sheep on stage. He's on Kiwi time. Now New Zealanders are what this little sheep. We have exported millions. Why? Well, it's a secret. Sorry, Captain. He is the most sweetest tasting meat in the world. Enjoy, Captain. Here comes the big boy. Roger Dawson down. Now, he is low in fat, low in cholesterol, but he's a quick maturing sheep. Ideal for the early lamb market. We use him as a terminal site. Cross with Merino down the south island of New Zealand. And lucky us! Come on, Chuck! Good old Chuck! Here in New Zealand, we have about 35 million sheep. 30,000 are still cut. You cannot die cutting. Very good financial garment. Excuse me, Rommy. It is time to stand up. Excuse me, folks. Come on, Rommy. Now, behalf of the EFL, I'm proud to present to you our 19 different breeds. Thank you. Now, we're moving right. This next part of the show is probably the most exciting part of the show. Please watch. Music! Awesome! Now it's time for sheep shearing. This is what you call a typical sheep shearer. Thank you. Thank you. You got the singlet, plenty of room, but no restrictions. You got the trousers. Double in thickness. Protects my dainty little knees from prickles that may mean the sheep's wool. Funny shoes. These funny shoes, they're called moccasins. Very good for gripping on the greasy floor. And now, Which sheep would you like me to shear for you?
Merino.
Merino, the number one sheep breed of the state.
Yes,
the number one sheep breed of the world. I mean, please. Who wants me to shear the Merino? Put up your hand. Yeah? Well, stand up. There's the door. We'll get a little sheep from over here. Been waiting 6 months for his hair cut. That's how long it takes to grow a good bull. There we go. We need control. There's our control. Now move the sheep. We'll take the handbrakes off. Now we'll move the sheep. Here we go. Sheep, relax. Relax.
Oh.
Hello. Hello. Smile. Watch this, I'll put my finger in the sheep's mouth. The sheep will not bite my finger off. He rather spit it out. Oh, yeah. Don't worry, tissue's my left. Excuse me, has anyone got a tissue I can use to wipe the finger? It's okay. I'll just wipe on top of the tissue. Legs hanging on, the hands are free. This is the staying piece. This is what we use to cut the wool from the sheep. On this side here, you've got a 13-tooth comb. It goes through the wool. On the other side, a 4-tooth cutter. It goes backwards and forwards, and then cuts the wool. Warnings, it's a little bit like shaving. First thing in the morning. Sometimes you'll make a mistake. Ah, you cut yourself. But it heals up very quickly, just like the sheep. Now, sheep are funny little animals, many things sticking out. Ears, nose, milk production. Hang on. This is not a girl. This is a boy. I've got to be very careful not to chop down. But do not worry, I am a professional.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. I've done this one time before. Then I shear the sheep using a bow and technique. Been around since the 1950s. Sheep, relax. Okay. And away we go.
You want to go there? Buo, no? Buong-buo. Tama nga, sheep. Hindi. Tama nga yun eh, para makahinga yung balat niya. Hindi. Every 6 months nila si sheep.
Parang nakagiwang ito.
extra naman. Pati tong mga to.
Dali.
Ito, matapos na.
Their belly full of grass will generate heat from inside out. And within 24 hours, the skin will double in thickness and toughen up. Now sheep, they have to fall off their legs like this to make it hard for a sheep shears. Let's get that handpiece underneath to get the wool. Now sheep have got what you call pressure points. One there and one there. Push that pressure point, up pops the leg, get underneath and get their wool. Here we go! What's this? Bing!
Boom! Oh.
And cheap. Left leg, height, come! Boom! And bow! Well done, sheep. Stand up now. Take a bow. Thank you, thank you. Bye bye. They got a haircut. Who's next? Price. Okay, average shear like myself will shear 350 sheep for 9 hours. World record, 721 sheep for 9 hours. That's under 45 seconds per sheep for the whole day. Incredible. Now let's have a look at our wool. We've got B grade, we've got A grade. Here's the B grade. Underside of the sheep. This is dirty and stained. Compare that to the main piece. That's a big difference. You wash that, that will not come white. It's stained. We use that for coloured socks, coloured singlets, they don't really need. B grade out you go. Now New Zealand wool is world famous for its quality. So let's feel some of that quality today. I want you to feel the natural grease that is in the wool. Here we go. Pass it around, pass it to the people behind you. Here we go. Feel the natural grease. What's that natural grease called?
Lanolin.
Lanolin oil, that's right. Very good for your skin. They use it for cosmetics, facial creams. I myself, I use it every morning. I rub it on my face. I'm actually 70 years old. I do. That's
right. That's enough.
Papasa mo sa likod.
Oh, thank you.
Now what is wool?
Wool is a miracle
of nature. It's a plain will not catch a lot. It will only smell.
Napicturean mo na sila. Ay, binalik na ni mama. Ayan na. Picture mo sila.
Let it go. It will bounce back to its original shape every time. That's why they use it in the carpet.
Finish mo sila, mama.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, may I have your attention, please? Please, smell your hands.
Oh.
What do you smell like? You smell like a sheep. Now, do not worry. Let's get rid of that smell. Put your hands together. Start rubbing, and the smell will go away. Rub, rub. The smell gone?
Yeah.
Oh, more.
Yeah.
Keep rubbing. Keep rubbing. Are you ready? Now, put it through your hair. I was only joking. Okay. Now, New Zealand wool. We sell the auction system. Just like our sheep, we sell.